piece of ass that she is, Jenny McCarthy. I think she looks awesome, especially when she was dressed very, very provocatively. Low-cut top, the boobs, shirt's real thin. You can see lots of nip. We keep it a little cool in here during her appearance, so...
Everything was just right.
Everything, all the stars were aligned, my friends. Her ass was all round and muscular. Round and muscular.
The rest of us are dressed in down jackets and wool hats. It's so cold.
Yeah. She looked great.
Got a great ass.
And, hey, you know, I didn't even mention today, legitimate supermodel. I think Fred will even tell you this. Carmen Cass is coming in.
I don't know who that is.
I don't know her.
I read about her in the paper, and I asked my girlfriend. She said Carmen Cass is, like, one of the most beautiful women in the world. She's about 25 really? Years old, and, like, she goes, you're going to think she's the most beautiful woman you ever saw. And I said, honey, hey, you're the most beautiful woman I ever saw.
Good answer.
Right?
Good answer. She is pretty.
She goes, that's okay. Knock it off. It's all right.
Yeah, it's okay.
It's okay. Yeah, that's just the way it goes.
When I hear the word Cass, I think of Mama Cass, so it turns me
off. This is a complete opposite of that, apparently.
Yeah, so we'll have a good-looking chicken here today. That'll bring my spirits up. I don't know. I think I'm going to get a little down.
Yeah, well, you know, there you go, throwing me out again, and now we'll have a good-looking chick here.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Well, that's right. I forgot about your weight loss.
We'll have a good.
You're not a chick. I told you that. You're not a girl.
I'm a guy.
Not
right.
to me. You're a guy.
one of the guys.
I tried to get that witch to hypnotize you to bang me. It's got to be a compliment somewhere in there.
just weed through all this stuff. You'll find one.
I think it's a compliment that I don't think of you as a chick.
I'm teasing.
No, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am. I don't care.
You don't cheer me up anyway. I can't get you. There's nothing going on there.
I love how a guy thinks that's a compliment. I don't think of you as a chick.
To me, that's a compliment.
To most guys, that is.
Like John Stossel. What a compliment. Courtney Love's in the paper again, man. They're saying she's out of control. She called me 3 times yesterday.
That's a sign.
2 of the times, there was no message. Just our radio show in the background during the Anna Nicole Smith thing yesterday.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
What was the third one?
Then it was like, man, you say much worse things about me. That bitch is crazy. Or I don't know if she said that bitch is crazy, but she said something about, like, Anna Nicole seems like a little... She goes,
She thought Anna was crazy.
Yeah, I think
That's
so.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah. But it's interesting. She always leaves her name as Courtney or Courtney Love. Now she's Courtney Love Cobain.
Really?
Yeah.
She's gone to the 3-name thing, huh?
Yeah.
Maybe that'll help her in court.
Yeah, this was in the Post today, though. Just ending what I was doing before the commercials. Hundreds complain of raunch. It's a big picture of me and a picture of Oprah. Faithful fans of Howard Stern are washing Oprah Winfrey's mouth out with soap. They filed 1,900 letters with the FCC complaining that the queen of daytime talk is filthier than the king of all media. And by the way, when you go on howardstern.com, there's a whole long section in there where you can take action, where you can write about other radio shows. And we keep listing all this stuff. And if you want to take action, it really helps. The angry letters which demand Winfrey be fined or banished from TV for a sexually explicit show. How can you allow Oprah Winfrey to discuss anal sex on nationally televised show at 4 p.m.? And then they list a lot of the letters. This makes it the second most complained about program after the Super Bowl, where Janet Jackson bared her breasts. Wow. On the controversial Oprah show, a writer for the host's O Magazine explained in graphic detail what she said were the popular sexual pastimes of America's teenagers, including oral and anal sex practices. Stern's anti-Oprah campaign began 6 weeks ago after he complained on his national radio show and on his website that the FCC is guilty of hypocrisy for hitting stations that air his show with multiple obscenity fines while letting Oprah slide. So there you go. Lisa Halliday, a spokesman for Oprah, said, "We have not been notified by the FCC of any indecency investigation. Blah, 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 blah." She don't know about it. She don't know what she's doing.
Blah, 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 blah. Huh?
big helicopter crash here yesterday. NBC, local NBC television news. Boy, they have no luck with helicopters.
They're always coming down.
Hmm.
I couldn't believe it was NBC again.
Yeah, I mean, they have, like, no luck with helicopters. One girl, the traffic copter girl, died in a helicopter crash, and there was another crash. This one, I think this is a third crash. Mm-hmm.
This was Chopper 4.
Chopper 4 was down.
Almost took out a couple people. Because you know what they were doing? They were covering some, like, police activity. There was, like, shooting going on.
Mm-hmm.
Then the helicopters show up. And they had to stop the whole shooting because the helicopter was crashing.
Sal, the stockbroker is in for Stuttering John's job. He wants to get Stuttering John's job. He'll be in. He's got another, he's bringing some new members of what he considers should be Whack Pack members.
Oh, is that what he's doing today?
Yeah. Including his father, which he scammed into coming down here. He didn't tell his father why.
Oh, dear. Hmm. What's he going to say about his dad?
And then we have that Fred game that...
He devised yesterday,
so Sal doing a good job. And while we're talking about censorship, real quick, I just wanted to say hello to Red Peters, who is so brilliant. Red Peters is a guy who's done a bunch of songs on our show, you know, song parody type things. And Red's most brilliant new song, it's his new single, is about things you can't say on the radio. And they're not letting us play it on the air. I mean, Tom took the song. Hey, Red.
Hi, how you doing, Howard?
Hey, brother.
Did he really take it off the air?
Well, he didn't take it off the air. What he did was he went back and re-edited your edited version to the point that I'll play you some of it. It's not funny anymore.
Oh, I know. He wrecked it.
He wrecked your song. And this is, again, censorship in its worst form because your song is so funny and sort of cute and a great sort of comment on censorship. And Red Peters' song cannot be played. Here's what Tom did to your song so you know what I'm talking about.
Okay.
Can you hear that okay?
Yeah. All right, I can.
They say I can't say these things. Oh, yeah. They tell me I can't say these things. Oh, no. Things like my oh my stick it up your
Tom K. Edwards
it's
said
brutal.
He said it's just as funny. Did you hear that?
It's hilarious.
It's just as funny. You don't even know what he... You, I mean, it's completely nothing.
Tom the Chump.
What the heck happened? Well, I don't know if it's any consolation, but I put the your version on howardstern.com, and then I linked to your website, redpeters.com.
Great. Thank you, Howard.
Yeah.
That's been great, man. Thank you.
I'm thinking of singing that song as my karaoke in Vegas.
You wouldn't dare.
I would love to.
Do the slow dance with Michael Powell.
Yeah, that's great, huh? I said, what a good video. Idea. Red wants to shoot a video for it.
Yeah.
And I said, well, we should get like a guy dressed up like the FCC guy, Michael Powell, and I'll do a slow dance with him while Red sings.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, where are they going to show that anyway?
So,
how you been, Ben?
I've been pretty good. My two CDs were re-released last week. I had to pull them about a year ago. I got mixed up with the wrong crowd, and I had to sit out for about a year or two.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know. I was wondering what happened to you.
Pardon?
What do you mean you were in the wrong crowd? Oh.
Oh, you know what I mean?
All right.
The people that invested in my last record, Old Blue Balls is back. They sort of dropped the ball.
Oh, Old Blue Balls is back. I love that one.
Yay!
Yeah. Well, I would have had to, proceed and play and really not make any money. They would have made all the money, so I just sat out.
Sounds like you were in a legal wrangle.
Right, I was. I've since squared.
See what happens
away.
To the great artists, Robin?
Yes, all these record company guys are all terrible.
Well, who knows? Red could be terrible. We don't want to get in the middle of it.
Terrible, Howard.
I'll tell you what, you're a super talented dude, man.
Thank
I love
you.
Your music, and you're one of the best. That's why I linked up to your webpage there. So
I appreciate it.
All right,
hey,
Red.
Howard, I was in a movie with your father.
What?
Oh, yeah.
The guy who played your father in Private Parts?
Yeah.
Richard Portnow?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was in a movie with him. As a matter of fact, we're finishing shooting it at the end of this month.
A real movie?
Yeah. It's with all these dudes from The Sopranos. As a matter of fact, the guy, Vincent Curatola, is the godfather in this movie. It's a comedy. It's called Johnny Slade's Greatest Hits.
Red Peter's song, I Can't Say These Things, is available at coolcds.com. And look for Red Peter's album, Music to Have Sex By, out later this year. For more information, go to redpeters.com or link up on howardstern.com. I'm sorry, Red. I love that song, man. I was playing the hell out of it.
Yeah, Tom wrecked it. Hey, I am working on a...
Look at you, man, with the plugs.
A Tom Schiasano safe version of that tune.
Oh, you can do it?
Yeah, actually, when you take the bleeps away, there's nothing offensive about the words.
Nick, if you could figure out a way, I mean, I hate to say this to an artist like yourself, to somehow... See, I don't even want to give in to that. Forget my request. I was going to say if you could redo it some way, but don't. It's ridiculous.
I mean, to have a song that's already bleeped, to bleep a bleep song is kind of sick, you know?
Yeah.
Tom was like, well, the bleeps aren't good enough. And I went, sure they are.
I don't know, man. Hey, it screws me. You know, I know it screws you, but it also screws me because I'm getting a lot less airplay around the country because of this whole beef.
So you know what's going on then. You feel it.
Oh, yeah. No, because in 96, when I Laughed, I Cried, I Fudged, My Undies came out.
I remember that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was great.
Bob Dole. Remember, it was the big Bob Dole thing. And he was saying, that such things were politically incorrect.
I remember when Fudged, My Undies came out. And I remember your problems with Bob Dole.
Yeah.
They got to do a VH1 Behind the Story with you.
Behind the music.
I did do a making of I Can't Say These Things. A film shoot of it.
How can we see that?
Actually, you might want to take a peek at it.
Where is that? I'm having trouble communicating. I keep talking and you're talking, but
I apologize.
It's my fault. What do I know?
Yeah.
All right, hey, Red, I got to go, man.
All right, brother. Thanks for playing the tune, and good luck with all your problems.
Thanks, Red.
RedPeters.com. Come visit.
Red Peters out.
Right on. Peter's out, if you know what I mean.
don't give up writing those songs, man. I love them all. That's Red Peters.
How's your home? Family, how's your home? Family, how's your home?
Family,
how is your whole family? How's your home?
How's your home?
Family.
Dictation machine.
Take your pants down to the cleaners today. Take your pants down to the cleaners today. Take your pants down to the cleaners today. Take your pants down to the cleaners today.
Guy could have had a legitimate music career,
but he decided to go the novelty route.
Yeah, he took the road less traveled.
Bold man. An innovator, if you will.
I can still play this song. That's so good.
Thank God.
To my ass. Trilogical shark, won't you my ass? Trilogical shark, won't you do my ass? Trilogical shark, won't you do my ass? Trilogical shark. Suck on a stiff cock.
Stiff cock.
Tail with me. Suck on a stiff cock.
Stiff cock.
Tail with me. Suck on a stiff cock.
Stiff cock.
Tail with me. Suck on a stiff cock. Tail with me.
Secret. Out.
and the crowd goes nuts.
You know what? They should do a Red Peters American Idol night.
Wow. I'd watch that.
That'd be great.
Yeah, the best, I said this early in the morning, I'll do a little recap. Paula Abdul is the best thing on that show. There's something really wrong with her. I mean, aside from the fact that she can't give an opinion, that thumb bandage and then her face last night, had something really bizarre going on. I don't know. I can't even describe what I saw. It was nuts.
And she sounded strange.
Yeah. I did a whole rap on Anna Nicole Smith and what happened yesterday. Do you think I should repeat that or just screw it?
I don't even think we should ever give her any more attention or time.
Okay. Because it was a big story on Extra TV, and I thought it was kind of interesting. But you know what? You have to listen to the whole show if you want to hear that. Our director, Scott D. Pace, had a baby boy. Congratulations. Our TV director from the E! Channel, Scott D. Pace.
Now, is he already in Las Vegas?
Well, here's the weird thing, and this is, I got to admit, this is bizarre. Scott was real nervous that we were going to Vegas, and he's our director, and let's face it, none of our crew wants to miss going to Vegas.
Right.
So.
The greatest time of the year.
Right. It's the most fun for us. We love being at the Hard Rock. So. Anyway, he was nervous, so what I'm hearing he did was he made his wife get induced. They gave her Pitocin and induced the baby to come out so he could go right off to Vegas. He didn't want to, because she would have,
she probably would have had the baby while he was there and he'd have had to fly back home.
7 months is enough for a baby to.
No, come on.
Yeah.
It's not 7 months.
No, I'm just kidding. Well, she was in her ninth month and she was due, right. Like, but they went and they induced the baby.
I'm all going to get a lap dance if you keep holding on to that baby in your
See, bed. I never would have done that. I would have just went to Vegas and missed the birth.
Right.
You don't want to affect the, you know.
Yeah, I mean, why should a baby have to come out early? He wasn't ready to come out.
Right, you just missed the birth. You'll see the kid.
But he had another son.
Another son, yeah.
Yeah, and he named him Derek.
Derek DePace.
As in Jeter, Philly fan.
Is that right? As in Jeter?
No, he's a Philly fan. And he names him after Derek. Of course he names him Derek Jeter. Come on.
He named him Derek Jeter DePace. Yeah, Derek.
Another little boy for him to wrestle with.
Another future homophobe.
Yeah.
I'm going to show you a picture of that Steve Kojic Ahogaho.
Don't be like him.
Better not, or I'm going to smack you upside your head.
That's good news. Congratulations, Scott.
All right, here's a bunch of email. Don't talk to John Stossel. He sucks. He had a show complaining that organic foods were not really organic and that people were wasting money on it. He got in trouble for it, re-aired the show. Then he was forced to tell the truth at the end of one of his 2020 shows. At about 10:55 p.m., he ran a two-minute retraction about the organic foods.
Is that right?
That's what, I don't know. That's what some dude's writing me. Robin's right. He attacks people. He's a stupid F with a 1980s mustache. I'm sorry you have to go through all these legal troubles. I love when you talk about it, exposing the government offices. John Stossel doesn't have the balls to interview the government officials, just you. Yeah, that's true.
Ah, there you go.
I compare you with poor people who lose children and then take on causes in the name of their children. I'm glad you didn't decide to back out quietly. Here's another one. If that's the John Stossel from ABC that wants an interview, you beware. I've seen him turn things around from other interviews that he's done, and he could completely make you look like an ass. Don't I know it? I wouldn't do an interview with him because he'll cut it up and misrepresent you totally. And by the way, you're absolutely right. And I agree. By the way, I saw Imus on The View. Gary was just showing it to me. I guess Imus and his young wife, Deirdre, were on.
On what?
On The View.
Oh, dear.
You know, because he gets on there because of his cancer ranch, which I still can't even believe is in existence. It is such an obvious way to get the listeners to pay for your ranch.
Now, if it's a cancer ranch, there should be cancer kids there all the time.
No,
right?
Not all the time.
Why not?
Well, I think they need some downtime on the ranch, don't they? So evidently, the cancer ranch money that he raises on the air, they buy all this surrounding land. You know. All right, Scott DePace wants to say something. We're on such a delay that...
Democrats
just
got to
bad,
us.
Republicans good.
Hey, Scott.
Hey, man, how are you?
Congratulations.
Thanks.
On Derek DePace. How many pounds? What's the deal?
8 pounds, 6 ounces. He's healthy. Had a circumcision last night.
There you go. Just like his dad.
Yeah.
We all have to look alike.
I would just like to point out, I didn't do the, we didn't have the inducing because of, you know, to make Vegas. I did it out of loyalty to work, not to have fun.
You shouldn't have been doing it at all.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? To be honest, she would have went yesterday anyway, so.
Sure.
Sure.
I swear to God, when she got there, she was 4 centimeters.
Come here, Crystal.
You know what I'm getting your kid for a gift?
What's that?
The EIB high chair.
Nice.
The excellence in broadcasting.
That sounds good.
Thank you.
Anyway.
Congratulations. Yeah. I'm glad DePace is going to Vegas, because you know what? It would be awful to have to work with a new director in Vegas. It's one of our most complicated shows.
That wouldn't have worked out.
It is a lot of work.
It is.
But
when are you leaving for Vegas?
I leave Saturday.
Enough time with that
How
baby.
How old will Derek be by then?
By two days.
Hey, Scott. I know. It's killing me, man. I already have Pam's going to email me pictures and all that sort of stuff.
We've bombed it enough. 2 days is enough time.
Yeah, the lighting guy can just set things up and camera platforms without me being there, right?
It's off the spearmint rhino. I mean, a production meeting.
All I know is they say if fathers don't bond with their children at a very young age, they can become homosexual.
You know what? Years from now, he'll be thinking back to, I left him for this trip, and look what happened.
Derek, what are you doing with a queer eye?
Dude, that would kill me.
When you're driving Derek to ballet 14 years from now, I hope you remember the Vegas trip.
All right, Scott. Congrats.
You're getting married. Where? Hey, Scott.
Yo.
Good luck with Derek Jeter DePace.
Dude, get out of here with that. I hate Jeter. All right, I'll see you guys.
Congratulations.
There you go. Here's a bunch of hate mail for Cabby. Here's a bunch of people who were disturbed by Elliot Offen on the E! Show. I mean, I watched that one. That was awesome. I could watch him. He is a train wreck.
He's the best. He's the best guest
He'll
ever.
He'll be in Vegas.
It's really weird. Elliot went off on my girlfriend when he was here on the radio, and then the E! Show didn't have it, and I was showing it to my girlfriend because I said, you got to watch Elliot. He really bashes you.
Oh, and it wasn't there.
Yeah, I was a little disappointed, but maybe for time purposes they had to cut it out. You know, you only get 22 minutes on that show. Jesus Christ, I just finished watching Elliot Offen on the E! Channel, and it scared the S out of me. The image of his disheveled, decrepit, horrendous red dress is burned on the inside of my eyelids. I seriously don't know if I'll be able to sleep tonight. Whoever's working the cameras for E! Needs to be fired. They continue to pan up and down his hideous body throughout the interview. A lot of people hate Sal, the stockbroker. You want to hear Sal? Some people love him, some people hate him.
All right.
If Sal wants the job, let him box Gary. That's one idea. Some people excited that tomorrow Sal is interviewing Beth.
Ah, they want to hear that.
They do. Here's one. I've been listening to your show since I was 12. I can honestly say that today's show is by far the funniest show I've heard. Sal's a tremendous radio talent.
Oh.
Hey, now.
He produced an outstanding bit. In addition to those several pieces, he isn't as good as Stirring John. He's better. Do not let Sal get John's job. He's a loser. I swear I will stop listening if Sal is hired. I tell you, everybody hates everyone. As long as Tom hates Sal, he's going to have my vote. By the way, on howardstern.com, you can see all the signs that Sal hung up around here yesterday.
Oh, when he was harassing Tom?
Yeah, he hung up all these signs. And I hope they show this on E! Sal, the stockbroker, made these really crude signs, like crudely made with magic marker.
He just took pieces of paper and just started writing.
Yeah. And Sal kind of hung up on the door where Tom works the delay button. He hung up, please stay out, Tom ruining show. And Tom came out and started ripping him down and yelling at Sal.
Yeah.
And supposedly they got it all for E! I'm dying to see that.
The Tom attack?
Yeah. So I can't wait to see that.
You know what? I walked in this morning. Sal's at it 24 hours a day. I don't know how Gary would ever be able to sit in the office with him for 3 months if he should win.
Baba Booey.
Because Sal was in there this morning, first thing with a, you know, those pieces of little paper that they sell or have in the paint store that shows you different colors.
Yeah.
He had a bunch of white ones, and he was matching them to Gary's teeth.
Well, that's what we're going to be doing today.
Baba Booey. He's always like, we're going to find the definitive color.
If only they were white, I'd be happy. They were all yellow.
Okay.
He's so crazy.
A lot of people wrote in, they love Sal's bit. That bit is great where we had to say things that annoyed us about Gary.
Yes.
And it's making my nuts and ass shudder with anticipation for the day we hear what is most annoying about Mr. Howard Stern. So people looking forward to that. Do we have that for today now? Can we play that?
I know they were getting that together for Fred. Today is Fred's day.
Well, it should be together already, no?
You know what?
We're going to play that at 9:30?
We have the CD, just not the, we have to transcribe the quotes, which will take like 5 minutes. But I think our model friend is here.
Oh, we're backed up, huh? You guys should get that stuff on earlier.
Hey, now.
Oh, well. I guess not. A lot of slacking off going on. Let me see if there's anything else good. Tell Howard to sing Cat Stevens' Moonshadow in Vegas. We want to hear it.
Yay!
That's one guy. A lot of people wrote in saying Anna Nicole is a liar. They don't like her. And I did my whole rap on her, so I'm not going to. The guy who runs Oxygen, the network that Oprah's on, has decried FCC censorship. He's come out against the FCC crackdown, which is good to see. I guess it's a woman. Geraldine Laybourne criticized the FCC's enforcement effort during the National Cable and Telecommunications Association annual trade show. I don't think we should use the word indecency. What we should call it is censorship. Stop saying indecency. Laybourne's comments came after a question and answer session with FCC Chairman Michael Powell and Robert Sachs. I don't agree with that, Powell told reporters. For 70 years, the country's had limits on broadcast television. To me, censorship is prior restraint, and I don't think anybody has been involved in that limitation or content. You don't even know what he's saying. His quote is unreadable. It's just, hey, there's always been rules and tough. Okay. I want to see that model chick anyway. Let me fix myself up before she gets in here. Maybe she'll find me attractive.
Hey, now.
It's a long shot, but it's worth a try. What do you think?
Anything could happen.
I could belt out a few sit-ups.
Here, wait. Let me get... I'll put someone on the phone while I do this. Yeah, hey. How you doing, Jace?
Hey, what's up, Howard?
Good. If you can't hear me, I'm putting my shirt on.
Oh, that's great, man. Wonderful. Hey, look, Howard. I don't know if you were watching American Idol at the time or if you were still banging Beth, but listen. Paula Abdul's thumb, the bandage around the thumb, it had sequins on it or little diamonds. I don't know if you noticed that, man, but it was freaking hilarious because she's like trying to decorate the bandage now.
Robin, do you think I look better in this shirt or the just the blue one?
You mean you have different
the blue
outfits?
Yeah, I have, like, do I look better with this shirt or with the shirt off?
I like that shirt. That's one of my favorite shirts of yours.
Let me get my shades.
It looks like old Blue Balls is back.
Well, anyways, Howard.
Paul
I just
Abdul.
Wanted to point that out about Paula Abdul.
Paula Abdul,
you know,
is something seriously wrong with her, I think.
Well, I just found it really strange. She's trying to decorate the bandage now.
Yeah, I think she's disturbed.
There's mud on her face. It looked like she had cookie dough on her face or something.
I'm glad I put this mirror back here.
I can't believe it. He has a mirror in the studio now.
Yeah, but it's hard to look at myself and do the show.
A little too self-conscious there, Howard.
Yeah, tell me about it. If you had this face, you'd be self-conscious, too.
Hey, man, I'm not a good looker either, so I already know what you're talking about.
Thank you.
But, hey, I was in Orlando maybe 2 weeks ago, and, you know, your show's not on in Florida or whatever.
Yeah.
And I was listening to that Latin channel, you know, out of curiosity, and I know a little bit of Spanish, and they stole one of your bits, too.
Of course.
Well, no kidding. They do my whole show in Spanish.
Yeah, but I know they stole the recent bit. They stole the butterface bit.
Oh, wow. It's unreal. There's no shame.
I was disappointed. I was like, these a-holes. You know, like, how could they do this?
Man,
you know?
The whole industry has ripped me off. I mean, I should be a billionaire based on the amount of ideas and concepts I've come up with.
Meanwhile, you're a horrible human being.
I'm disgusting.
There's nothing good going on.
No talent here, but they all take my stuff and don't credit me. Michelle, you're on the air.
Hi, Howard. I just wanted to thank you for talking about your colonoscopy. It made me go out and get one.
Everything okay?
Yeah. It wasn't bad.
I'm a regular Katie Couric.
And I think you should talk more about it because a lot of people aren't going to do it because of what Katie says, but will do it because of what you say.
You know what? You should have had yours on the air.
I got to tell you something. I would talk more about my colonoscopy, but I like to do it in a humorous way, and I would probably be fined for my humor talking about colonoscopy and stuff that, you know, has to go into your ass.
Right,
I'm sure that'll be bleeped. Everything's bleeped.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I talk about the fact that I got done with the colonoscopy and there was a brown stain on the piece of paper, and, you know, and that would all probably not be allowed on the air. So welcome to George Bush's vision of America where everyone loves Jesus.
Well, you have to hang in there till November.
Well, I don't know that that's going to be possible, honestly. But thank
you. We're
all
hoping.
Well, yeah, me too. Well, whatever. I just can't even stand being here anymore, be quite honest.
How's your colon?
Oscopy.
How's your colon?
Yay!
Well, let me take a commercial, then we'll come back with that incredible piece of ass.
Yeah, give me some time to prep
up. What is
up.
She doing here?
I don't know. Carmen Cass, and I'm not really sure who she is, but my girlfriend told me she's like the most beautiful girl on the planet.
Yeah, I think I've seen the name in like gossip columns and stuff, but
I think
really
she's
know.
Like number two behind that...
Bunchen girl?
Bunchen, yeah.
Giselle. Yeah, she said, my girlfriend said, I'm going to freak out over her.
Really?
That's how hot she is. And I said, honey, I'm with the best. I can't possibly freak out over another woman. Which was so the right answer. And she goes, you know, shut up.
So the right answer. Yeah. Nobody bought it for a second.
And by the way, before I go to break, though, I saw Imus on The View. Here's what I was going to say.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I got to tell you, it's frightening. I mean, I don't
what
even mean it.
Like?
I don't even want to make a joke. I talk about karma kicking you right in the ass. He's a horrible man. And his, I've seen him do horrible things. He's sitting there next to the young wife. How she has sex with him, I doubt they have sex. I mean, I can't, I almost look like he could barely walk to the stage. I'm going to show you.
Really?
And then when he talks, he barely has a voice anymore. He almost can't talk.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, I'm going to play you some of it.
All right, I can't wait.
And, you know, he's all serious about his cancer.
Yeah, because he's out collecting for cancer, right?
And he's busy promoting his wife's book about cooking.
At the cancer ranch.
At the cancer ranch. I mean, don't ask what those two are up to. And I mean, and she's getting a whole, I guess she gets a whole life off of it from Imus.
Of course, now she's on The View.
Yeah.
That's
and
exciting.
She looks, and she literally looks like she's there with her grandfather. I mean, it's unbelievable.
She looks like she's there collecting money for his hospital's back.
Yeah.
Yeah, this man needs help.
It really isn't a joke. He looks like the Crypt Keeper. Exactly like it.
Wait, he comes out with the big cowboy hat, and him and the wife are dressed the same, like with a tan jacket and a tan shirt. And,
yeah,
I mean, it's real. I don't know if it'll come across audio-wise, but here, go back to where he's
walking in.
Yeah, all right, well, I guess people can't see that, so it's...
All right.
Notice that kids who are... who have cancer or blood disorders.
Rewind. Mr. Cancer. Yeah, okay, that's good.
What the heck was that?
Are you really suffering being with us today?
Yeah. No.
You really?
No.
This is an act of pure love, right? Okay. An act of pure love. Lots of aspects for her.
I'm happy to be here. This is thrilling.
Your expression, how delighted you are. Let me talk about the Imus Ranch first of all, because this is a 4,000-acre ranch that Don and Deirdre did from scratch for kids who had cancer, have cancer, other kids who are suffering from diseases. And, you know, there are a lot of things you could have spent your time on and your
yeah,
money
like,
and effort
like,
on.
Like your lungs.
Why this, Don? What made you want to do this particular camp in this particular place?
Well, we had been raising money for kids with cancer for the past 15 years, and I was raised on a ranch, and we had noticed.
I won't. Wow. Do you believe it?
Oh.
And the big giant cowboy hat?
That hat is a 50-gallon hat.
God damn. What happened? I mean, you know, he has no lungs, I guess, anymore. Or...
And he's chewing on the gum. But literally, he looks like this clothing is too big for him. The clothes are just hanging off him.
He can barely walk.
And he's got those old man jeans on.
Yeah, oh my God, grandpappy.
That are almost up to his neck.
Yeah, it looks like I almost...
That's like when your father gets some jeans.
But I tell you, my dad's 82 and he's in better shape than I am.
I mean, he looks like a dead body that wasn't discovered for 3 weeks.
Yeah, I mean, seriously, really? I'm not even making a joke.
Neither am I.
I mean, my dad's 82 and is more sort of limber and spry.
Yeah.
What happened to the guy?
He looks like...
Was it all the coke and the drinking and the...
Somebody should call CSI. They got to find out how he died.
I'll tell you. I hope it's not from coke and drinking, because
that's what you're looking at.
Yeah, dude, maybe you ought to sober up.
Or just hopefully die before I get to be 80 like him.
He's 64, I think.
64.
He looks like he's 85.
He can't be 64.
All right, let me quick break.
Do you think, though, because his skin looks a little bit smooth. I think he had his skin, like, lasered or something.
Well, you know what? I think they...
Why? Why bother?
I think they put some makeup on him for the autopsy.
You're trying to look youthful?
I'm trying to look youthful.
All right, we're going to take a break, and then Carmen Cash, supermodel, will be here. Do a quick break, Fred, because it really...